saw the whole thing! I saw the whole thing walking back from the candy cane depot. I saw the whole thing!
Okay, looks like we have an eyewitness here. What's your name, sir?
Don't matter what my name is! I seen what happened. A polar bear got into the workshop and started eating L's. I don't know those L's, and I don't work with those L's, but those L's are gone!
Well, good evening, Nick. You're looking very well tonight.
Well, that's very kind of you, Nick. You look great, too.
Guys, I'm gonna jump in here. How is this possible? I'm looking at two identical Nick Cages.
Well, Seth, I can explain if you just calm down!
Welcome to J-Pop America Fun Time Now, celebrating Japanese culture, fashion, and music.
You shut your mouth!
Yeah, you shut your mouth, boy!
Yeah, that's right! You better show this woman some respect! Maybe you don't know who you is!
You in Maine now, boy.
That's right. You call her by her Christian name, lest you won't get tossed out in the marshy swamps of the New England Everglades.
And trust us, if the gators don't get you,
yep,
the North Atlantic trout will.
That's right.
The voices.
Are you Indiana Jones? You do Harrison Ford's voice?
No. Clip.
Oh, you got a clip?
Yeah, clip.
Oh, great. We'll roll the clip.
The good man comes to me and says, "Thank you, Gandalf, general manager, for this job." I say, "Okay, you can talk the talk, but can you walk the walk? Vis-a-vis, aka, for you, to maybe one day end up here in the hot seat, Lord of the Rings."
Some new friends. I apologize for being so awkward.
No, you know, that's quite all right. That wasn't very neighborly of me, and I apologize. Bob Peterson.
Jeff Montgomery, pleasure to meet you.
You know, this doesn't excuse my behavior, but I hope you'll accept a Reese's Peanut Butter Cup.
Bob, I couldn't think of a better welcoming gift. Oh. Thank you.
And just out of curiosity, what exactly is your Halloween costume?
I'm a sex offender.
Talking about what you want for your last meal.
A man.
Sorry?
For my last meal, one man, please.
No.
Two boys?
No.
Okay, fine. One boy.
No.
Fine. Shake Shack.
I just think that a lot of people might rather hear about the Titanic, you know.
Oh, my God. Okay, wow. Okay, fine. You want to do this? Let's do this. First of all, you came to where I live and you hit me. It was midnight. I was chilling.
Gruber?
Darrell.
It's Daryl.
Jazz me over that fly shoelace, you dig?
Gruber, I don't know if this is working out.
That reminds me of a good joke. What do you get when you cross a Mexican with a black?
MacGruber.
Excuse me, a black African-American. Mo better?
Yeah, mo better.
Okay, so you cross a Mexican with a black African-American and a Jew and a woman, and what do you get? I don't know, but I sure don't want that person to move in next door to me.
From spring to fall, I never met a flame that I couldn't handle until my gown met a candle.
We can skip me. Happy Halloween.
Let's try this for real. I don't like that.
Okay, who had the grandfather who choked on a meatball parm? Everybody, okay. His name was Sal, short for Salvatore. Well, they're all at peace, and they're all bowling.
Hey, let's go over the rules. A Lifetime movie, Tanya, will walk out, and you'll have 15 seconds to guess what's wrong with her.
There's nothing wrong with her!
Yes. Yes, there is.
For it has the two key qualities of a classic Nick Cage action film. Number one.
All the dialogue is either whispered or screamed.
And of course, number two,
everything in the movie is on fire.
So what time is it?
What the hell is wrong with this blasted thing? Amanda!
But the latest technology isn't always easy to use for people of a certain age.
These kids done bought me a busted machine again. Odessa!
Hey, no. What's Seinfeld?
Well, you know, the TV show.
Sorry, kid, I don't own a TV.
Okay, but you've seen Seinfeld.
Hey! I told you! I don't own a television!
So you've never heard of Seinfeld?
Look, kid, I go to museums, I read books, I hate TV. I walk into a room with a television and walk right back out. You get it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, I'm sorry. Okay.
Go get some Stop and Shop cornflakes in the welfare bag. Oh, what's that look? Oh, you gonna take a swing at me? It's today the day, huh? It's today the day you take a swing at your old man? Is that what it is? Come on, you a man now? I didn't think so.
Was your mama a human and your papa a bear? Or was your papa a human and your mama a bear? Or was it they both bears and when you were a baby bear, you were bit by a human?
What?
So he comes in the door, right?
Right, okay.
All right, walks in like this. Oh, come on!
You're doing Kramer!
What?
You're doing Kramer!
I don't know what you're talking about.
It's Dylan McDermott or Dermot Mulroney.
We will never know this.
Correct answer was Dermot Mulroney. Next round, tell me, contestants, who's this? As a reminder, the answer for the last round was Dermot Mulroney. This is the other guy.
Can you say both their names again?
And before I turn around and go like, what? Half my ass is gone. Which was my best feature. And I'm literally injured, but all anybody cares about is that like, 40 or 50 people died or whatever.
Well, it was 1,500 people.
Why are you attacking me? You said you would be my Oprah, Colin.
I never said that.
Well, someone did.
The world with little note, nor long remember what we say here, oof. With dialogue that clunky, I'm surprised he was shot by an actor. Oh, is that too soon? Get over it, he's on the five.
You're in first.
No, what are you talking about?
Oh my God, it's JFK, we solved it!
It went, okay, all right, look, it is not JFK, all right?
It's his brother.
Why would,
Dennis?
No, why would you think that's your brother?
I don't know. Okay. Is it Morris Day in the time?
You think this man is Morris Day in the entire band, the time?
Maybe he's just Morris and a couple of the guys.
Okay.
I'm John Hamm. If you're looking for a romantic night out at a restaurant that specializes in pork dishes and fine champagne, then look no further than Ham and Bubbly.
It's actually pronounced Bublé.
Well, Bublé doesn't work, so now it's pronounced Bubbly.
View of a Weekend Update appearance I did. The best part about this one was his interaction with Colin Jost. No, it's crazy. Like, look at the picture they use of you, right? Now look at the picture they use of me.
Pretty. And today we have with us our colleague from the South. He's an American journalist quarantined in Canada because of COVID-19. Please welcome from Detroit, Michigan, Jean-Fred.
Merci for having moi. but my name is actually Fred.
Correct, I said Jean-Fred.
No, just Fred.
Ah, bon, please welcome Jean-Fred Desjardins.
Okay.
Let's begin.
To inform you that I'm a repeat sex offender, and I'll be living in your neighborhood. It's a great costume, right? Could you sign and date these, please?
Santa, no! He knew that fence was old, and he didn't replace it, because it cost 5,000 more gumdrops than he wanted. Our peppermint blood is on your hands!
Listen to this sexy-ass elf right here!
Tanya's back on the swim team.
Yes.
The girls at school are saying Tanya is easy.
No!
Tanya has bruises on her shoulder.
Tanya!
Judges? This next question is for $250,000. and we've got a walk-on clue.
Hey, Doug, it's me. I'm one of your closest friends.
Hey, Todd.
And I've been his girlfriend for 4 years. What's my name?
Yeah, we won them all! French and Indian War!
Won it!
King Philip's War!
Killed it!
Lexington! Conk it!
Crushed it!
And now Bunker Hill!
The best one yet, kid!
Let's open up our present!
Well, I got a Nerf gun.
I got a hat.
I got an autographed baseball bat.
I got a telescope.
I got a globe.
I got a watch.
And I got a robe.
I got Hulk hands.
I got a tie.
I got a copy of The Catcher in the Rye.
I got a drum set.
I got a phone.
I got a pen.
And I got a robe.
I got an outdoor.
No longer Jeff Metcalf. I am Captain Tornado, and I'm doing this for my town.
Okay, Captain Tornado, go get him. As a reminder, he'll have to beat Sam's time for the qualifying round.
That's right. How have you been, by the way?
I'm depressed. No reason, really.
Well, you hide it great. Let's see if Captain Tornado will be our next American Ninja Warrior. And he's off!
He'll be a millionaire.
A millionaire? From fur trapping?
From coal?
No, from popular songs.
What sort of songs could make a man millions?
I don't know. Maybe something like, Cry Me a River.
So, he'll be a girl?
No.
Grab him by the neck. Bite him. Take a little nibble out of his arm and nibble on it like corn on the cob. Nom, 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 nom.
Wait a minute.
Are you saying you want to eat your younger self?
Does that make me rehabilitated? Yes, it does.
Exactly. And look, Paul Manafort and Rick Gates, look, we barely knew these guys. And as for the last guy, George...
Dr. Octopus.
No, buddy, it's not George Dr. Octopus. It's George Papadopoulos.
George...
Papadopoulos.
Papadopoulos.
All right.
Weekly segment with our Toronto correspondent, Awasen. Awasen, bonjour, hi.
Bonjour, hi. I'm Awasen, and this is Drake Watch.
Ah, yes, our favorite part of the show where we find out if you saw Drake.
So, Awa, did you say Barack today? No. This has been Drake Watch.
Straight up to me, a black elf in sweatpants, and asked me to keep her safe. That's how bad it is.
My friends are still in there.
Girl, they dead.
In the film, Disturbia.
I'm not really a beer drinker, but this might change that.
This is the kind of beer somebody brings to a party at your house, and then it just like sits in the fridge for like 8 months. And then one day your buddy comes over and he's like, hey, you got a beer? And I'm like, well, you know, I got this pumpkin.
So you drink it and it, you know, gets you buzzed.
Oh, come on.
I'm coming.
You've been sitting there for half an hour and I'm
enjoying myself. You know, you're just like your mother.
Oh, there you go.
Of course I do, of course I do. It's Missy. Audience. Todd, I'm so sorry.
Interesting choice to apologize to him as opposed to her. Guess you just don't consider her a human being.
What kind of horrible game show is this?
It's What's That Name?